Hi children, let us solve question number 7 of exercise 6C. Children, this question is a bit lengthy but not difficult. Okay. Children, you just need to understand how the speed, distance and time of the two trains which they have mentioned in the question are related. Okay. If you get that understanding, then the solving part will become a cakewalk. You see how it happens? Children, they are talking about two trains. One is an ordinary train or a local train, and the other one is an express train. Isn't it? Now, the local train is starting its journey at 6 p.m. and the express train is traveling its journey at 8 p.m. That means there is a gap of 2 hours, isn't it? There is a gap of 2 hours in between the starting of the local train and the express train. Keep this first point in your mind. Now, the local train travels at a speed of x kilometers per hour and the express train travels at a speed of x plus 20 kilometers per hour. Okay. Now children, the total distance that this local as well as the express train has to cover to reach a particular station or a destination is 1040 kilometers. Okay, both these trains have to cover the same distance, 1040. Now they are asking, if the express train reaches 36 minutes before the ordinary train reaches the station, that is after covering 1040 kilometers, then what would be the speed of the local train? Otherwise, find the value of x. This is what we have to find. Okay, so let us understand this question with the help of a small diagram. Okay, children, here I have written 6 p.m. and here I have written 8 p.m. This black line which I have drawn is for the ordinary train and this black line which I have drawn is for the express train. Now see, 6 p.m., 8 p.m. If you notice, I have written 6 p.m. for the local train here and here 8 p.m. for the local train, isn't it? I will come to this point later, but before that, let me just discuss the parameters which we have to write for both these trains. For the first train, the distance and the speed. Children, I will talk about this distance later along with this 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. Okay, first of all, the speed of the local train is assumed to be x kilometers per hour. Yes. Now let us discuss for the express train. The speed of the express train is given as x plus 20 kilometers per hour and the distance that the express train has to cover is 1040 kilometers in order to reach this destination. Okay, now children, you must be thinking, why I discuss about this distance traveled by the local train? That is what I'm going to discuss in the next point. Children, try to visualize. The local train started its journey at 6 p.m. but the express train is starting its journey only at 8 p.m. Isn't it? So did you see that gap of 2 hours? But children, if you notice, in that gap of 2 hours, the local train has already covered a particular distance, isn't it? It started the journey at 6 p.m. So from 6 to 8 p.m., the local train was continuously traveling, isn't it? So definitely, if the total distance is 1040 kilometers to be covered, out of that, already some distance has been covered by this local train in those 2 hours, isn't it? Because when we are comparing two quantities, we should see that there is no partiality or bias shown in the comparison. Children, here the express train was taking rest from 6 to 8 p.m. It started its journey at 8 p.m. onwards, isn't it? So in that gap of 2 hours, this local train has already covered a particular distance. So when we say the total distance to be covered by the express train it has to be 1040 kilometers. From 8 p.m. onwards, it will start its journey and try to reach the destination, which is at a distance of 1040 kilometers. But that is not the same with the local train, isn't it? Because the distance traveled by the local train from 8 p.m. onwards has to be calculated when you are establishing a relation between these two trains, isn't it? So children, let us find out what is the distance covered by the local train from 6 to 8 p.m. and how much distance is left out for this local train to cover from 8 p.m. onwards. Okay, children, this is that time interval, 6 to 8 p.m. So in this gap, how much would be the distance covered? We know distance is equal to speed into time. The speed of the local train is assumed to be what? X. So I'll replace S with X. How much is the time taken by the local train? 2 hours, isn't it? So can we say the distance covered by the local train in those 2 hours is 2x kilometers? That means when you start comparing the local train and the express train from 8 p.m. onwards, how much would be the distance left out for the local train to cover? 1040 minus 2x. Are you getting the point, children? The leftover distance for the local train to cover is how much? 1040 minus 2x. Okay, if you don't do this calculation, that means we are showing partiality with the local train, because we are giving him an advantage of 2 hours, isn't it? But that is not done. When you are doing a comparison, you should see that the starting point is the same for both. Okay, the starting point is the same for both, and at the same time onwards, you are doing the calculation for distance, speed and time. That has to be kept in mind. Okay, now children, that's why I have to, distance is equal to 1040 minus 2x. Hence, the time taken by the local train will be how much? Distance upon speed, that is 1040 minus 2x upon x. And here, the time taken by the express train will be how much? 1040 upon x plus 20. Okay, this part is clear. Now children, let us establish the relation. The difference between the two times is 36 minutes. Yes. Here we know speed 2 is greater than speed 1. Speed of the express train is greater than the speed of the local train. So it implies T1 is greater than T2. The reciprocal, isn't it? So children, T1 greater than T2. Therefore T1 minus T2 is equal to 36 minutes. Now let us substitute the value of T1. 1040 minus 2x upon x. Isn't it? Distance upon speed. This is the distance, this is the speed. I have already mentioned it over here, children. Okay. So here, this minus this is equal to 36 upon 60. So this is the basic equation that we have got. Clear?